Bob, Clown John Bob on board. Eric Stevens, truck mechanical, Salisbury. Budweiser's on board with him this year. Salisbury's easy. Big Dog Clown, so he's got a lot of help on that machine. Also number 11 going by with the open field division.
That's Jimmy Thorpe. Man whose idea is coming to you here this afternoon.
Dean's a rookie on the circuit this year too, eh? Bill DeLuxe.
St. John O'Dillon, the number 14 over the wheel.
Hatfield's a pretty common name in the sport.
Yeah, Hatfield's and the McCoys. You go down south. Lloyd Halpin from St. John in the number 5 car. Again, you're seeing repeats of generations, and this is why we are so happy to see some new blood get into a great old sport in a brand new division.
One thing about this division, I'm sure they're going to have on hand a lot of front end parts. A lot of these cars look quite a bit wider than your typical sportsman division. There's not a whole lot of sheet metal or, you know, roll bars around the wheels. These guys. Another date you want to mark on your calendar for this season is the 2nd and 3rd of August. There'll be no stock car racing at the facility, but there'll be no shortage of action. If you look out behind us over in the backstretch behind the pit area, you see a state-of-the-art motocross facility, and we've got the Canadian National Championships for motocross this year here, so you do not want to miss that event. It's action-packed. These guys fly. Again, that's August 2nd and 3rd. Be sure to check that out. As I mentioned, later on in the season, August 17th, Ciblinas Roofing and Siding International, celebrating its 39th birthday. So it's the longest-running, most prestigious racing event at New Brunswick, longest-running speedway here at the Oval of Excitement, River Glades Speedway. Also down in the canteen, great Father's Day gift. They've got racing excuse t-shirts for just $20. Great gift for Father's Day. It's got a nice list of excuses there, of reasons people go to the racetrack week in, week out. And I'll tell you something, on a day that's 20 degrees, or we've been very fortunate to get some great weather, not a much better way to spend a Saturday or Sunday afternoon at the Speedway, seeing some action, enjoying the great weather. Drivers could not be here week in and week out without the sponsors, so certainly take notice of the sponsors. To see any of them, make mention that you saw the name on the side of these cars at Riverglade Speedway, and the drivers would certainly be appreciated. An escort is Mike Larkin from Riverglade. Outside of him, I just mentioned a little bit about him, number 60, Mike Wiggle. He was having some mechanical trouble over in the pit area, so not sure how that car will perform. Right behind him, in the number 8, Acura Integra from Salisbury, is Eugene Wiggle. Right on the back bumper of Mike Wiggle in the 10, the lone female out there, ladies. That's April Berry, second-generation driver. A lot of second-generation drivers out there. The 26 is Jesse Rogers. Berry dives to the inside as he enters turn one on Wiggle. 84, Mike Clark has dropped back to third. Eugene Wiggle holding a steady fourth down the backstretch. Berry to the inside. As they exit turn two, still side by side, Wiggle with a slight edge as they head down the backstretch. Berry comes back hard in. Two down, 8 to go. Eugene Wiggle in the 8, moved up to 3rd. Jesse Rogers not on his tail in the Honda. We got a Jesse Rogers is not mobile on the backstretch. So we've got three down and seven to go in this opening heat for the next generation, and so far... So, assistant flagman Winnie Burnham will get these folks lined back up, and we'll run the last seven laps of this opening heat for the next generation. So we got them realigned, three laps down, seven to go. April Berry on the point for the restart. Outside, Mike Wiggle in the 60. Right behind him is father, number eight, Eugene Wiggle. Mike Clark is still there in four. Berry on the inside, Wiggle on the outside as they head down the backstretch. Five to go. Wiggle hard on the inside. Berry on the outside. They head down the backstretch. As I mentioned, trouble for Wiggle as he exits turn two. Hard into the retaining wall. Right front tire. So hopefully Mike's okay.
It's gonna be one of those days, I guess. Job.
So we have six down and four to go. Six laps down, four to go. And a tough break for the young campaigner from Salisbury. Second. Another date you want to mark on your calendar coming up later on in the season. It'll be July 13th at 6 o'clock. We've got Quaker State Sportsman Memorial 80. We'll be announcing the format of that a little later on in the season. But we'll have a Memorial 80 lapper again. Probably expect a large purse for that and a large turnout of cars. We've got six down and four to go. For that second position. If you'll remember, he spun out here just a few laps ago and he's making his way back up through the field towards the front. Rogers takes over the second spot from Wiggle as they hit down the backstretch. Yeah.
outside pole, the number 90 car, also from St. John, Frankie Lowe. Then the 80 car will be in the second row. That's Ian Kruger from Shinnyak. The number 6 car is Lowell Affleck.
On the outside pole, the number 90 car of Frankie Lowe. Then the 80 car of Ian Kruger. The number 6 car is Lowell Affleck. The 11 car is Kruger. Is giving starting lessons to Doug Wright. Doug doesn't know which ends up, so in an elevator he'd never get that job. But anyway, when they go around, should get the green this time around.
Those 50-50 tickets, we'll be doing the draw very shortly, so dig out those 50-50 tickets if you pick them up in the pit area or over here on east side of the grandstand.
One more time. You probably noticed these folks are running slicks. For a long time, this race of slicks been in use in a division here in Atlantic Canada, and these guys are on them. So we'd like to give a chance to warm up even in this beautiful day here at Riverglade. The racing gods have shined upon us, no doubt.
after 10 months of freezing cold, we're back to our four seasons of June, July, August, and winter.
They're running slicks, Les. These folks are running used slicks, though, correct?
That's right. Two divisions running slicks now, Atlantic Canada and the Pit.
Looks like the 60 car is still under repair over in the pit area. He will be unable to make this semi-action. On the point for this one, Denny Gaudette in the 91, that beautiful orange Chev Celebrity. The artwork on that, really intense. Outside of him, the 26, Jesse Rogers. Inside, row number 2, the 10 of April Berry. Outside, she picked up the win in the heat, so keep your eye on her. Outside in that Acura Integra number 8 Budweiser machine, that's Eugene Wiggle. Rounding out the field in the 84 Ford Escort, that's Mike Larkin. Ten laps of competition as they come to the stripe. Semi-final action. as they enter one. Rogers opening up a bit of a gap. In pursuit of that 26, Jesse Rogers and the CRX as they head down the backstretch. Rogers still with a good size lead. Looks like the 84 is missing one or two, and that's not a good combination. Rogers down the backstretch. Barry kind of gets that lead that he had. Seven to go as Barry looks to the outside as they head down the backstretch. As I mentioned, this division is a great division to get into to get started out. April. As I mentioned, tomorrow afternoon, 2 o'clock, we've got the Sportsman 150, the Little Bo Peep 150, presented by Hanson Signs. You do not want to miss that event. Huge purse on hand. $3,000 for your winner, $1,500 for second, and $1,000 for third.
If I ever have children, I hope they listen as good as these folks. Very few run. That's a first.
We're still waiting for the number 14 car of Cal Hatfield.
Thank you.
second and third.
outside, and the 90 car goes through the Saturday afternoon slide.
Videotaping the races here at the Oval of Excitement each and every week. You can go over and see Paul's race videos and pick up a copy of the week's action for just $12. So be sure to go see Paul if you'd like to capture some of the action. Like that in the backstretch where these guys probably wish they had some fenders.
I don't think that would have made any difference. A look like that's going to twist the rear end up no matter what.
Go up in the other way.
Who's coming?
back over the pit area. Grooming has been done.
Now, Pat made a trip to Daytona a few years ago. Daytona has a leak.
Of Jesse Rogers, inside row number 2, the 8 of Gene Wiggle. Outside in that Chev Celebrity Orange Machine, number 91 of Denny Gaudet. The 84 is Mike Clark, and the 35, that new Tempo or Topaz, is a new car to competition. I believe that's being driven by Kirk Steves. And rounding out the field, he's been working pretty hard over there in the garage area, the number 60 of Mike Wiggle. He's kind of taking the shine off a little bit. Not sure how that 60 machine of Wiggles will perform if you look at the right front of it. In the three, and out of turn. Barry jumps out to the early lead in the 10 machine. 26 Jesse Rogers right there behind the 8 of Eugene Wiggle in the third spot. That 60 car looks like it's moving pretty good. Switched jobs for this race. The 8 now being piloted by Mike Wiggle. The 60 being piloted by his father, Eugene Wiggle. They've stopped for this race. Mike and Eugene, and they hit down the backstretch. Barry comes over to the leading
negotiating some lap traffic down the front chute. Mike Swain, G-Drive, in the third spot, Mike in the fourth.
Thank you.
cars now all by himself on the lead lap. Next time by, we're halfway, 25 down, 25 to go.
Time by 43 down, 7 to go for Mike Wiggle.
just lets the faster Rogers machine sneak through, knowing he's a few laps down on my pit side earlier on. One more lap to go for the Wiggle machine, number 8, Acura Integra. Regular campaigners in the Sunday Driver Division, so he'll pick up the prize money for that. As I mentioned, Tiffany Lowe, our junior fan with the AOW Open Wheel Circuit. So Mike Wiggle in the number 8 machine driving his father's car after some misfortune early on in the heats with his own, brings it to victory lane for the first time this season. Let's hear it for him. Number 8, Mike Wiggle.
Okay, for your 35 lap feature, we're getting steady instructions from the big guy, Brian Burns, rumored to be Doug White's body man. It said protecting that body should take a lot. There's number 4, Bruce Martin. On the outside, number 5, Roy Helton. Number 9, Mark Price. 6 is Roy Lethwick. The 80 car, Ian Kruger. The 90 car, Frankie Lowe, 83 car. Corey Little. The 96 car, there he is. The man to watch, Chris Garnett. He's got 2 checkered rakes here today, going for the triple. The 3 car is Dave Murphy. Yeah, that's got to be Dave. And the 00 car of Dave Burnham. Ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, let's wave our hats as they come around for that pace laps. This really turns drivers on as you can wave for your favorite driver. Thank you.
likes that high sound.
Thank you.
first. Checkered flag history has been made today at Motorgrade Speedway in Atlantic Open Wheel Racing. Let's hear it for the man from St. John, number 96, Chris Cannon.
Is going to pick up second, and number 80, Ian Kroger, Chris Garnett in that APM out of St. John Baldwin Filters. Filter us, TCI manufacturing the XI batteries, the General Freight Carriers and Wicked Signs car, bringing out the checkered lobby.
Finishing its car in the second spot, the number 9 car, Mark Royce.
Rossi, he's sponsored by Happy Face Cabinets. Palazzo's Pub and Eatery, Wick's Tully, Shipley's Drywall, City Radiator, and Standard Auto Glass. Ian Kroger, Ron Helm, the Ray in third spot out of Shediac, owned by Freddie Kroger, sponsored by Monarch Construction, Shediac Auto, right to Maritime Muffler Sales and Service, Shediac Brake and Suspension, and Ruby's Custom Sheet Metal. Ladies and gentlemen, let's hear it for Atlantic Open Wheel Racing. Put your hands together, folks. You've given us all a lot of fun for bringing that here for you this afternoon. On behalf of all the staff here at Road Grade, and especially the crew and staff from Atlantic Open Wheel, all the racers, you don't know how proud we've been here this afternoon to bring you history here this afternoon at River Glade Speedway, where so many racers have cut their teeth on their first clutch in racing shoes.
Also keep in mind, if you folks want to get a closer look at some of these open wheel machines, you're more than welcome to head over to the garage area at the conclusion, which anytime now. Tomorrow afternoon, 2:00, we've got the Little Bo Peep 150 for the late model sportsman division brought to you by Hanson Signs. We'd love to see you back for that. Expecting another nice day in terms of the weatherman, and we're expecting 35 to 40 late model sportsmen in competition tomorrow afternoon. As you exit the speedway this afternoon, please be careful of the children, the other cars. Take your time, and we look forward to seeing you back here tomorrow afternoon.
Corey, thanks. It's been fun working with you, as you do with my wife and daughter every week. There he is, picking up the hardware. Again, one more time, let's put our hands together for this afternoon's historic race winner, Chris Garnett from St. John, New Brunswick.